Hey everyone, Roddy here at Klebs Tech, and today I have some crazy and wild stuff. We've got a lot of LoRAs to talk about today, some a little crazy, some a little useful, and some I don't even know how to explain. And of all these LoRAs come from the same person. Now, if you're not familiar with LoRAs and what they are when it comes to stable diffusion or focus, I do have another video that covers them a little more, but the basic idea is that they're supplemental models to your main checkpoint, and they add something that that model may not be trained on. It can be styles, people, animals, many other things. Now today, we're gonna be looking at ones that are pretty much all styles. Now LoRAs will often have trigger words, and all of these do, that will activate that style. But do keep in mind, if you have a LoRA enabled, it will still influence it somewhat, even if you don't use the trigger word. Now today we're gonna be looking at some of RalFinger's LoRAs. Now I say some because there are a lot. There are some pretty wild styles in this collection, and I will say that most work really well. I did find some that did not give me the greatest results, but in all honesty, I didn't spend a lot of time on each one. And even if you're not looking to create things completely with these styles, they do also work well with inpainting when you need that one thing in an image that the standard checkpoint just won't give you, like a dragon made of lava, for example, or one made of tree branches. There are really so many styles in this collection. So let's start by going through some of the ones that I've experimented with and tested. Most of these, I did use the Mohawk checkpoint, which is geared towards character design. If you have not tried that one out, I do recommend it. I'll probably do a video on that pretty soon as well. Okay, so before I start looking at all the different individual LoRAs and showing you some example images, I did go ahead and generate something just to show you anybody that's not familiar with how the trigger words work. So I've gone ahead and generated an image here. I've selected, now I'll go ahead and select, I'm using Fooocus. Obviously this works in any user interface. Now most of his nowadays, he starts with RAL, but some of the older ones do not, but it's always the first part. Some of these, it would be RAL beer or anything like that. So it makes it a lot easier with the trigger words. You don't have to go looking those up and remembering them. Now I'm just gonna add it at the end. Obviously if I added it at the beginning, it would probably give it more weight, things like that. But I just wanna give you an idea of how this ends up working. And we'll go ahead and generate. Okay, as you can see, vastly different results, although she is awfully small, but that gives you an idea of the effects that that had on that, and that's how the trigger words can work. Now, you can try to target the trigger words by, with some of these saying made out of, and then use the trigger word, and sometimes that'll work. I find sometimes just using the inpainting with that as well, if you don't want the whole scene. But that's not, I'm not gonna jump into that. I just wanted to show how the trigger words work for anybody that wasn't familiar with that. So the first one up is our balloons LoRA. As we can see here, the trigger word is balloon with a Z at the end. This was done on the Mohawk checkpoint. I found these came out pretty good. This is actually a very good one. You could have a lot of fun with this one. And we have our dish soap angel. This one, it was hit or miss on the results that I got out of it, depending on what you're designing. As I said, I didn't spend a lot of time on each one. This is actually, it took me quite a while to go through, download them all, test them all out, and do everything. These were interesting results, I will say, that I got out of these. Now, one of the ones that I did like an awful lot was the explosion one. This one's Darth Vader smashing a watermelon. Came out pretty good. I got some really good results out of this one. This is one that I definitely will be using quite often. And we have our fireworks LoRA. This one I got some interesting results, although it was hit or miss. Some things worked well, some things just didn't look as well. So it's kind of one of these ones that depends on the prompt and the effect that you're going for. Potentially lowering the weight on some of these as well can help. Then we have our lava LoRA. Now, this is another one that I was very happy with and I used quite a bit. I started using this one because I was trying to design a sword made out of lava, and this ended up working out very well. So this is definitely one that I'll be keeping in my list. Then we have the overgrowth one, which I just showed a moment ago when we first started. Same idea. This one, sometimes you have to use extra weight, sometimes lower weight. It depends really on the image that you're working with. I found, like in this one, I had to increase the weight because if I hadn't, it didn't really show much. Then we have our 3D cubes LoRA. This one's another one that I found very interesting and I had a lot of fun with. I'll be definitely returning to this one and using it for a lot of different things. So 3D cubes is definitely one that I found quite interesting. Then we have our beer one. So this one is a little hit or miss, same idea. Some things didn't come out as well. I did find I had to put it towards the beginning. You know, I could put stuff made out of RAL-beer, things like that. So this was interesting. I like beer, so I had to try this one out. Now this one's a slightly different type of style, but this is the exploding one. This one's the dissolve one. Same idea on this one. I found in a lot of stuff, I had to increase the weight on this one to get it to really show the effects. Some images, I had a hard time at all just putting the trigger word in there, but then increasing the weight on it, like on this one, I put 1.5. It had a definite impact on that. So if using the dissolve one, definitely try using a higher weight if you're not getting the results that you want. This is another one of the dissolve. Same idea, I had to use a much higher weight to get it to show. If I didn't, it didn't come out that well. But this is one of my favorite ones out of his so far. I've been experimenting with it a lot and I do like it. Just need to increase that weight on it. And of course, some of the weird ones, we got our fried egg LoRA. And honestly, at first I didn't think I was gonna be using this much, but I found myself using it quite often. It is actually very entertaining. And if you need fried eggs, it does a pretty good job on those. And we have our mold LoRA. This one, I haven't gotten exactly the results I was hoping out of this. I do find it quite interesting, but I need more experimenting with it. I saw some of the example images online. Seemed to be a little better than what I was getting, so. And we have our porcelain LoRA. So this one's the princess dancing at the royal ball. This one I didn't have to increase the weight or anything like that. Found the results work pretty well. I was able to use it with in painting. I used it to create a porcelain sword. So this one worked very well for those sorts of things. But this is also the type that you may not want to use completely all the time for the whole image because it does tend to cause some of the stuff in the background. But you can probably use made of RAL porcelain when you're talking about an object in it, and it might do better when it comes to just generating that. Then we have our sand LoRA. This one's another one that I had a lot of fun with. We have our Darth Vader and Stormtroopers here in the sand. So if you ever wanna create sand castles or any sand sculptures, this does pretty well for that. And we had our tree branch LoRA. Another one I had a lot of fun with, some of these really weird ones. There's a garden hose one. There's some other ones that are pretty wild. You can get some really interesting results for some of these. And there's another one using the tree branch. And it's interesting what it decides to make into tree branches. And we have our toilet paper LoRA. This one was okay. I don't see myself using it much, but it was entertaining. And we have our wool LoRA. This one I found was pretty interesting. Definitely one I'll keep on my list. I can have a lot of fun with this one. It does make for some interesting characters when combined with the Mohawk checkpoint here, which is good for character design. And for our hops LoRA, I had to try since I do love my hops. This one is kind of on the weird side, but why not? I did generate some more that I'm gonna leave running for the rest of the video if you wanna check those out. If you found this video helpful, please do consider hitting the like button because it definitely does help. I do have a Patreon account set up if interested in helping support the channel, and I'm working on a custom GPT for ChatGPT that is designed to help with focus, and we'll be looking for a few people to test that out as well. You can just ask it about the styles and it will tell you what gets included with the styles, no digging through style sheets or any of that. And as for helping with prompts, well, it doesn't do that good of a job yet for that. Well, thanks for watching and have fun creating.